SEBI unveiled broad changes to India's insider trading and delisting regulations. The market regulator has widened the definition of who is an insider. The timeline for delisting has also been sharply reduced from 137 days to 76 days. To discuss the implications of SEBI's measures, I'm joined by Prithvi Haldeya, Chairman and MD at Prime Database. Prithvi, many thanks for joining us. Let me start with, you know, delisting. Does reducing the delisting timeline to 76 days safeguard the scope of manipulation, that it restrict manipulation in that sense?
Yes, so I think that reducing the timing is also a good measure. It does not keep the issue hanging for a long time. It also reduces the possibilities of price manipulation or other malpractices. And I think that's also a good process. And because you're introducing, you've done away with a lot of approvals. You've also done away with the paper kind of physical format and come on a structured platform. All these will contribute to reduction in timelines. And I think that again is a good move.
Prithvi, there was a concern that a successful delisting was done largely because of a tacit understanding between the company and a bunch of investors. Do these norms address those concerns?
Yeah, so as I said earlier, earlier delisting could have been done once you reached a threshold of 90%, which means that you did an understanding with some large shareholders and reached 90%, which means 75% is only with the promoters. If you could garner another 15% shareholding, you could go through the delisting process. The new element of minimum 25% by number of shareholders is therefore going to do away with this cartelization or with this kind of manipulation, because now you'll have to really reach out to small investors and encourage them to delist.
Sure. Let's talk about the insider trading regulation that have been clearly made more tighter. My question is, how will SEBI be able to monitor immediate family? How will SEBI monitor the definition of, frequent communication with company officers, people who are technically insider? How do you see that change?
You see, it's a good point. The law has been enlarged, the insider trading law has been enlarged to cover various kind of scenarios. And therefore, it will become that much more difficult for an supposedly insider to get away. Will SEBI look at every single trade which is happening at a stock exchange, and there are millions of such trades happening? Obviously, no. SEBI already has an alert mechanism by which it tries to pick up unusual trades. I think that mechanism will have to be strengthened. And once you strengthen that mechanism and are able to identify, peculiar kind of trades, and then you start questioning those people, then obviously you will figure out whether it was a case of insider trading or not. And once you're able to prove that it was insider trading, then you take appropriate action. And therefore, that acts as much as a deterrent to potential insiders, in the marketplace. So whether it is, the definition of who is a connected person, who are insiders,
right,
frequent communication, right, all these are basically to cover various kinds of scenarios, so that people are not able to, make use of any loopholes in the regulation and get away.
Sure.
And finally, the onus of proving that it was not an insider trade rests with the trader.
Right.
And he has to once. Obviously, SEBI cannot be looking at millions of trades on a daily basis.
Right.
It will have to, strengthen its surveillance. And develop very intelligent mechanism. For example, in case it is found, it can be found easily that there is one particular entity which trades, 10 days before a quarterly result every time, and sells within 10 days or 15 days or 1 month of the publishing of the quarterly result.
Sure, Prithvi, just one final question. The initial feedback from the market has been positive by most market participants. My question, therefore, is, you articulated that there are many kinds of insider trading. Will this put an end to the majority of the insider trading that we are seeing today?
You see, there is one extreme view, and I subscribe partly to that view, that if I am working for a company, for example, if I am an employer of a company, I have the whole market to trade in. Why should I be allowed to even trade in my own company shares? Because I am going to have access on a daily basis, and therefore I'll have the temptation to buy and sell in my own company shares. So that's one extreme view, that there should be a complete ban on such insiders relatives, directors, employees. But that is obviously not a very practical view because there are ESOPs and there could be, you know, promoters who would like to dispose of their shareholding for any personal needs or for expansion or whatever. So you cannot put a ban on these kinds of things. But obviously, since you are an insider and you have access to insider information, you see, published information is what goes out to the market on a quarterly basis until and unless there is some very significant development which you want to take to the market. But an insider actually has information about the company on a daily basis, you know, how new orders are coming in, what is the execution, issues with marketing, employees, etc., etc. And therefore, he knows that, you know, any of these or all of these will have an impact on the price once this information is released to the market.
Right.
And therefore, he has the temptation to trade. So more restrictions you have on such insiders, the better it is because, you know, in America, for example, there's a whole school of thought which thrives on information which is released by the insiders to the stock exchanges about the insider trades. So, for example, if you find that a particular promoter is continuously buying his own shares from the market and he has to report those trades to the stock exchange, then there's a body of investors which believe that the promoter, since he has access to insider information and is buying, therefore the prospects of this company appear to be better.
Sure.
Therefore, we should also buy it. So they ape, in a sense, the promoter or the insider. And vice versa for selling. In case the promoter or the CEO is selling, then there's a body of investors which start selling also because they think that this person has insider information, he's selling regularly, and therefore we should follow it.